So in order for us to better understand and improve medication safety, let's try to look at the medication distribution system. Typically in the hospital setting, there are three phases, which is first the prescription, prescribing, where the physician prescribes the medication order for the patient. And the second phase is the dispensing phase, where the pharmacy will receive the order, will pick, check, and send to the respective ward, ICU, ER. And that is the dispensing phase. And of course, there is an alternate path whereby for critical patients in ICU, there's also impress stock that nurses draw and dispense med from the ward stock for emergency purposes as well, from the impress stock. And of course, the third phase is the administrating of drugs matched to the patient at the bedside. And there are three phases. So before we move to the next slide, I would definitely ask you to think, sit back and think, where potentially is the area has the highest potential of medication error? Well, it is not easy to answer this question because, of course, there isn't a lot of public information on medication error incidents that that is actually can be found. But in every hospital, be it as a nurse, pharmacist, as a hospital administrator, you know you may have tracked and probably have encountered an experience with a near miss. You would know. So I have did some research on the web and I managed to find some statistics to be able to share with all. Could you go to the next slide, please? Could you click on there? So this is actually a statistics that I've gathered and it's public information that actually draw, from the Hong Kong Hospital Authority. Hong Kong Hospital Authority is a statutory board that manages 42 hospitals, all public hospitals across whole of Hong Kong country. So we can see from here of the three phases, dispensing inpatients stand out significantly. And that is actually very alarming. And of course, the first position, which means the highest, is wrong drugs. Second is wrong strength and dosage. And of course, third is wrong patient, wrong label information. So of course, every hospital, every country, every practices may have the different, you could instill practices, checks and processes, and of course the data. But this is statistics actually, publicly available that I've obtained. And you can see that inpatient dispensing is really critical. Let's, beyond medication safety, there are also other associated medication management challenges. So as a nurse, I believe you have this experience. Critical patients now need medication, but you need to be sent from the pharmacy up to the ICU, and it takes typically a period of time, 30 minutes or so. So it takes time, but you need it now because the patient really need that meds, because it's in a critical condition. And of course, to the nurse, I believe you have narcotics and control drugs, and it's always lock and key. There is a lot of administrative time taken from handing and taking over of those narcotics and control substances. And that is actually time spent, but which can be better deployed for patient care. And of course, for the pharmacies, it's all about daily pick, you pick and check to make sure it's right before you send to the wards and ICU. And that is really routine. That can be potentially an error. And that is actually where we want to focus, because human being, there is still a potential picking error, because you could be distracted and you could be a name that is similar, look alike, sounds alike, and you may have potentially made an error. And that is actually also a problem. And of course, the pharmacist is also medication management. How do you manage expiry and recall of the meds that you have dispensed? That is also NAR. And of course, diversion. Diversion doesn't mean that the drugs walk away on its own, which means that it doesn't mean it is a theft, but it could be patient, so-called nurse that requires a meds urgently to have taken out, but have forgotten to lock it down in the book. So could it be a diversion? And of course, to the hospital administrator is legal medical issues, and of course, subsequently impacts the hospital reputation and patient care quality. So let's look at some of the best practices. So in United States, they do recognize this problem many years ago, and they have really gone through this. And I'd like to share with all, and of course, this is actually from United States. They have decentralized, they have this automated dispensing cabinets that actually put in the ICU wards, ER, that deploy and has all the commonly used drugs already there, locked, electronically locked, ready to dispense when they receive the electronic order to the ADC. Likewise, you see the adoption rate has grown tremendously over time to 39% in 2010, and likewise similar growth in Canada. So in BD, we have Pyxis, and this technology is very mature. We have over 27 years, so near 3 decades of in the market. And you can see from here, so this is actually the automatic dispensing cabinets. It integrates with the hospital information systems where the ADT, which is admission, discharge, transfer information, is integrated. It is so-called when patient is admitted to ward 52, the information alerts were sent already directly to the ADC. And nurse will have the ADT information available immediately. So it's leveraging on technology. And when the doctor prescribed the order electronically, that order will straight away fire to the pharmacy, and the pharmacist will check, verify, once okay, he will approve electronically and will be immediately available on that screen, which is on the computer there. So you can see that it is very fast and in fact reduce the turnaround time. So this is all about leveraging the IT. So in the area of medication safety, yes, it's very important, medication safety. So what I mentioned about just now, I mean, of course, the orders, instead of so-called manual delivering the med to the ward and ICU, now the orders are available already in ward 52, and the nurse can go and dispense. And when the nurse go and dispense, you would just use the biometrics lock-in. The patient names will appear straight away. The nurse in charge will have my patient list available. And you can click on, it's a touch screen, you click on it, and it's a drop down. The number, type of match is already indicated on the screen. And by the touch of the finger, the drawer, which is here, you can see it opens up. And the right mat, the pockets, which is called QB, where mats are inside, only that mat QBs will open up, and the nurse will be so-called, will take out the number of tablets from that QB. So, thus, and so-called improving medication safety. And that is also one. And now the other safety feature is that your duplicate patient name alert, assuming you have two names with the same last name of Black Lily, I mean, of course, and Black Lauren, they will show you in red, caution, nurse, you make sure you select the right patient and so-called able to select. So it definitely, in this case, enhance your safety, medication safety. And of course, very importantly for, I mean, hospital in the private segment, it supports JCI standards. When we design, we consider this so-called standards very strict in our design, and we support JCI standards. So you can see from here, it is highly configurable. So all these, on the left-hand side, you see the pictures there. There are different sizes, QB, where you can put, depending on the inventory that you want to stock in the wards and ICU, you can have different sizes. And all these, on the right-hand side, you see the different sizes. It is configurable. If you need tomorrow more Panadol in that ward, you just remove and put a bigger box. It is like Lego. Any day that you want to change, you have to can remove and you put in the next one. And more importantly is that you can pre-fill this in the pharmacy, and this box is electronically locked, and bring it to Ward 52, replace it when the inventory runs low on the ADC. So that is actually a so-called another safety security feature. So to the IT folks, is very important because we are all in the IT world. The ADC, which is in the wards and ICU, is you can imagine them like is at every PC station, they are networked together. And all these are connected to a server in the pharmacy. And they can generate report, and they can control the formulary. And it's integrated with Active Directory, can do user management more effectively. And of course, you not only can have control of one a report of so-called of the inventory within the same hospital, you can connect and for a cluster of hospitals together in the enterprise system. So as a pharmacist or chief pharmacist, you can manage a group of hospitals in a particular cluster, and you have visibility of the inventory level. You can do trending, so you know what type of stock that you need more and which one you can reduce. So it helps you manage your inventory turn, and that is actually the advantage of IT, to the IT here. So I just want to share with you, one testimonial from this King Abdullah is from Middle East. So this hospital has 50 Pyxis med station, and you can read from there. I'm not going to read the details, but more importantly, they deploy this, and it is all about patient safety, and it largely improves not only the in terms of workflow, the number of steps, but also you look at that in terms of the nursing dispensing of narcotics and control meds, it's largely reduced from the before 25 minutes to 6 minutes. So it does really helps also improving patient care. And of course, before nurse will have the only the key, will able to open that so-called locker. If she goes to the toilet, you look for her. But right now you don't need to, because the system will have a double two witness lock-in. As long as you have so-called another nurse to witness, you can dispense the control and narcotic drugs straight away. And that is actually an advantage over there. So in terms of management-wise for the pharmacies and the medication management, there is great reduction because there is a so-called, formulary management, and as well as the user account management is much more easier today through IT. And that is actually, this is from King Faisal Hospital from the Middle East, which has installed 100 med stations. So a quick fact to share with all, Pyxis has more than 400,000 units installed globally. And we are the market leader in this field. These solutions, we are the strongest player in the US. And this is actually the facts. We have this Pyxis is largely used to address inpatient medication safety and management. We have also another solution called ROA, which address outpatient medication safety and management issues, which I'm not going to share now because we have a booth actually at the next door. Please come visit us. We will be able to explain you, we have videos able to show you, because in view of the time, I'm not going to so-called show the video. But please do visit us in the next door, and we will explain you more how technology can help improve medication. So in summary, our technology helps improve clinical pharmacy and of course also drive safer medication practices and have also reduce improve cost efficiency and transparency. So it is time to rethink and improve patient care in this changing healthcare environment. Thank you.